today. The Nassau Coliseum is full. It is noisy. The New York Islanders and the Philadelphia Flyers are on the ice.
I hope we don't sound like we're going to be shouting all afternoon, but that's what we might have to do.
Jim, all along I've been saying it. You know, it's great to retire, but I wish I was down there right now. The tension, the enthusiasm is going to be tremendous today.
The game underway, the Islanders in the home uniforms, white with blue and orange. The Flyers in the road, orange with black and white, as Bob Daly's pass was almost intercepted. This is Bobby Clark. Reg Leach is 27, shooting the puck in as he's knocked down by Dennis Puckman, and the puck is steered to center ice. The Flyers have Daly, number 2, and DuPont, number 6, on defense. Up front, Clark with 16, flanked by number 7, Barber, and number 27, Reg Leach. The Islanders' Bob Lorimer has the puck on defense with number 5, Puttman. This is Bob Bourne, joined by Trottier on the left. Can't reach the pass. Put it around behind the net. It goes to Barber in the corner. Trottier, Bourne, and Bossy, the starting forward line for New York. As Reg Leach's shot hit Puttman, who steered the puck out. This is Bourne. The Flyers are on a change. The shot is stopped by Peters. Had a little trouble with it, but he stopped it. Covering the short side. As Philadelphia on a line change almost got caught. In goes Ken Linsman. Holmgren shot. The play was offside, but you didn't hear the whistle in the roar of the crowd. Lane and Holmgren are squaring off as if to fight. Holmgren still hasn't dropped his stick. Lane has. And the shoving match goes on as the officials try to keep a lid on things. We've played one hectic minute. We're going to cool them out.
There's Gordon Lane of the Islanders. He's in the penalty box along with Paul Holmgren. They have both been set off 2 minutes high-sticking at the one-minute mark in this first period.
I'm Jim Robson with Gary Dornhopper and Dick Irvin. Dave Hodge and Don Cherry also with us for Hockey Night in Canada, Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final. Teams are 5-a-side. Wilson shot deflects high into the crowd. Holmgren and Lane got minors for high-sticking at 1 minute. So at this stage, the teams are 5-a-side. Pat Quinn, this year's winner of the Coach of the Year Award, the Adams Trophy.
And raised a few eyebrows, Gary. He made reference to the comment about the Islanders not being able to win the big one in the playoffs, which I think you can forget about now, but Quinn brought it up after the game in Philly Thursday.
A lot of gamemanship going on. Of course, Pat, you ask him about this series. He said, just imagine how many guys wish they were in the same situation we're in. Not only myself behind the bench, but the players competing in the Stanley Cup playoffs. The Flyers are certainly concerned about the fast start that the Islanders have been getting. They've been outscored 9-4 in that first period, and perhaps they may change their forechecking a little bit, possibly only send one man in and have two guys picking up the wings. That'll be a closer checking format, but you don't get many good chances against you. We'll see as the game progresses.
Puttman has the puck back of the net. No score in the game. Dennis Puttman, the captain of the Islanders, moving in on Ben Wilson. The shot right on. Peters knocks it down, covers it up. Not dressed for the Flyers today. Five players who took the warm-up. Frank Bathe, Dennis Bjerregaard, Gary Morrison, Norm Barnes, and the player injured in Game 5, Tom Gorentz.
Gorentz, John Paddock, who scored a goal in one of the games here earlier in the series, is in uniform. No changes for the Islanders. They have been unbelievably healthy throughout the entire playoff campaign. They've made only one roster change during the playoffs. That was when Mike Bossy was injured earlier on. He missed five games.
Dick, we might wonder if that will be a factor. You know, the Flyers have only had one day rest prior to this sixth game, and perhaps some of those injuries are, you know, questionable. We will see.
Holmgren and Watson have come back to play after being injured earlier in the series. Busnick of the Flyers coming out, looking ahead to Barber. Can't reach the pass. It slides to Billy Smith, pushing it to the corner for Langevin. Barber bounced him. Wayne Merrick is number 11 of the Islanders as Langevin is bounced by Barber. This is Stefan Pearson with the puck. Flipped it over Barber's stick to Langevin. No score, nearing the two-minute mark. Langevin to Merrick, joined by Tonelli. Tonelli from behind the net, centering it for Merrick. Tonelli going to the puck. Peter scooped it away. Stefan Pearson to Langevin. Back for Pearson. There's a lot of early line juggling as they try and match up forward lines. Of course, the home coach has the last say in that, but a lot of changes on the fly might dictate who plays against who. Flyers on another fast change. Langevin with the puck, moving in on Daly, who knocked him down. Good clean check. The crowd doesn't agree, but now there's going to pay a penalty for high sticking to Moose DuPont after Daly had thrown the good body check. Daly is looking anxious, but I think DuPont is going to get the penalty.
Andre DuPont in the penalty box for high sticking at 2:24. Not a good penalty, Gary. Daly had just made a super check on Lajvet. He had two good body checks in the game so far. Flyers had control. DuPont was caught.
Well, it seems that the Islanders just wait for this situation. 13 power play goals so far. That's the reason that they have this 3-2 lead in series. And they've certainly got the right guys out there. Watch them move that puck around. And the situation 4-3 is ideal for them.
And there's one of the key players, Brian Trotte, leading the playoffs in scoring with a record-tying 27 points. Stefan Pearson with the puck. Out there with Pat Van Bossie and Trotte. Pat Van turning away from Clark. The pass to the inboards for Bossie, centering it. Trotte couldn't control it. Now steers it back to Pat Van. Over to Stefan Pearson. It's a little tight, having trouble controlling the puck, and Clark comes up with it with Daly. They're 2-on-2. Clark will kill some time, plays it back into his own zone to Jim Watson. He's come back to play with a very sore shoulder, clearing the puck down the ice. There's 3 seconds left in penalties to Lane and Holmgren. They come on the ice. There's Paul Holmgren. But the Islanders still have the man advantage. Now 6-5. Teams look a little tight the way they're handling that puck, which goes out of play at the New York bench.
Well, that's something we talked about. You know, for the Islanders, the heat is on them today. They're not even thinking about a seventh game, but they're worrying about this one. I'm sure they were nervous before the game. We look at Mike Bossy, and it's important for the Islanders to get off of that good start, to give them confidence, to ease some of the tension, just as much so as for the Flyers to keep them off the board. Because the longer the game goes, it may swing over the Flyers' favor.
1:15 left in the penalty to DuPont, which was assessed at 2:24. Islanders with a man advantage. Bossy upset Bridgman on the faceoff. The puck goes loose. Bossy bumped by Daly. Peters leaves the puck for Watson. Trotte checking him, tying him up. Clark Gillies to Trotte, back of the net. Puck is underneath Watson, covering it up long enough to get a stoppage in play.
That faceoff play when Bossy dumped Bridgman, Bobby Clark was on his feet in a minute, giving it to Bob Myers. Well, when this game is all over, well, this gentleman on the right of your screen, John Ziegler, president of the National Hockey League, will he be involved in the post-game ceremonies? He is there along with Mr. Ted Huff. Mr. Huff, the head of the Canadian Sports Network.
That's Leon Stickle, the big linesman, and there's a guy about the same size, Clark Gillies, 218-pound forward with the Islanders. But a baseball player, too, played in Covington, Virginia. Said he couldn't hit the curveball well enough, so stuck to hockey. Very successful at that. 3:26 played, first period, no score. Gillies with the puck. Now Potvin to Pearson, checked by Barber. Bossy from the corner. This is Trotte centering it. Peters saw it all the way, and it's cleared down the ice. Philadelphia's penalty killing, of course, has always been strong. And this year, though, it was ninth in the league in percentages in the regular season. And they led the league in penalties again this year. Bossy to Potvin on his left, Trotte. There's the pass for Trotte, took it off his skate. Gillies now at the left point, weak pass. Stolen by Daly, scooping it out. Flyers make a change in their penalty killers. Bobby Clark, Reg Leach, bounce off the bench. 18 seconds left in DuPont's penalty, no score in the game. Bossy with the puck. Potvin moving in on Leach, the pass now for Goring. Gillies shot wide, Goring tied up at the side of the net by Ben Wilson, now goes in to check Daly. Puck came in front, Potvin shoots. Oh, Peters got his hand on it. Goring from behind the net. Flyers are back at full strength. DuPont is getting in the play right away after coming out of the penalty box. He rushes to the puck with Leach. Leach moving in on Potvin. They go to the corner. Leach centering it. Quick shot. Smith kicked it aside. The shot came on the left side from Ben Wilson, who now goes to the puck. Nearing the 5-minute mark, first period. No score. Teams making changes on the fly. Daly with the puck. Rolls into Islander territory. Icing waved off. Lindsman streaking in on Morrow. Hits him back of the net. Battle for the puck. Morrow gets it around to Bob Bourne, a very good skater. Sutter's on his right. Merrick is trailing the play. Bourne in on goal. Checked at the last minute by Jim Watson on a great rush by Bourne. Watson bumped by Bourne. Morrow hits Hill, but the puck comes to center. Lindsman streaks after it. He can fly. So can Merrick, who got to the puck just ahead of him. Two very fast skaters. No score in the game. Teams at full strength. Bourne took a hard hit from Hill. Sticks come up a bit. Dwayne Sutter bumped at center ice by DuPont. Linsman hit by Sutter. Lane has the puck. Gord Lane almost lost it in his own zone, recovered by John Tonelli. Flyers make a change on the fly. Tonelli in on the defense, trying to go through. Tonelli shoots, missed the net. Checked at the last minute. A lot of great individual rushes by the Islanders. They're not able to put that puck in the net. Little rough stuff at the boards between Morrow. Here's a fight. It's Bob Nystrom and Bob Kelly. Nystrom of the Islanders, Kelly of the Flyers, and they'll let them go at it. Stickle is the linesman watching. He'll wait to see if anyone gets an upper hand and then move in. A lot of tugging going on. Nystrom a bit bigger. There's the Flyer bench, of course. Nystrom throwing right hands.
Well, they're really going at it. You know, this really tires the players out from a Nystrom standpoint. You know, how effective will he be in the rest of the game? Now the officials go in there, but boy, that is very difficult. Because for the rest of the period, they'll hardly be able to lift their arms.
Terry, did you mention why the officials seem to take so long to break it up? Was it that difficult?
Well, perhaps they wanted to let them get it out of their system and get it over with. We could see a fight coming, and that'll possibly just put an end to it.
Pat Quinn, back of Reg Leach. There's Bobby Clark, an assistant coach.
You know, this is a big power play for the Flyers. They want to see how the Islanders react by getting an early goal right in their building, and you'll never get a better opportunity than right now.
Kelly and Nystrom got majors for fighting. Nystrom got the extra minor for that push in the face you saw that really started the fight at 5:55 of the scoreless first period. Each team has had 9 minutes and penalties. No score in the game. Islanders who are not dressed but are on their roster, Jean Potvin, Steve Tambellini, and Anders Keller. They've pretty well gone with the same lineup throughout the playoffs. As you look at Ken Linsman, nicknamed the Rat, from Kingston, Ontario, came out of the WHA, 21 years of age and a great future in hockey. Ben Wilson with the puck. Flyers with a man advantage, no score in the game. Linsman moving in. Bumped by Potvin and knocked him down, and Potvin is going to get a penalty for it. Probably a cross check. So the Flyers will have a two-man advantage. They're getting their goaltender out for six attackers right now. It's Holmgren with the puck. Peters is at the bench. Six attackers on the ice for the Flyers. Barber to Linsman. To Barber, a shot, deflects wide. Potvin gets the puck. A cross-checking penalty will be called on Potvin for a minute and 26 seconds. New York will be two men short.
Terry, I can never understand why a team with the penalty being called doesn't get a whistle right away. Then they will have a longer stretch at a two-man advantage. They wasted about 25 seconds right there.
That's right, Dick. That's a very good point. And, you know, a lot of times players talk about that. Coaches remind them they would have been better off just dumping in the corner and don't even go after it. Let the Islanders gain possession.
So it's Potvin for cross-checking at 6:29. Here is the reason. Linsman had cleared the puck along the boards. Potvin at Linsman from behind. And it comes now with a minute and 26 left in the original Islander minor penalty to Nystrom, the one being served by Gary Howitt.
That's a bad penalty for Potvin to take at this stage of the period, giving him that two-man advantage for the Flyers. And it would have been just as easy to take Linsman in the boards without using the stick.
Two hands on the stick off the ice, an obvious cross-check as Bobby Clark prepares for a safe off, face-off against Brian Trottier. In Islander territory, no score, 6.5 minutes gone. A loose puck in front. Lane lost it to Rick McLeish, taking his time to set up. Barber's at the left point, Wilson's at the right point. Wilson winding up, fakes a shot to Barber. Takes a shot, missed the net. Wilson will keep it in at the right point. Trottier watching him. Barber, passing, tipped away by Lane. Islanders two men short for another minute and 3 seconds. Wilson to Leach to Wilson. The shot, missed the net. Lane digging it out. Hurried back of the net. Reggie Leach with the puck for Clark. Wilson to Barber. In the slot for Leach. Missed on the short side high. Barber. Wilson on his right is Leach. On his left, McLeish and Clark is in the middle. Rick McLeish for Leach. Reggie Leach scores, and it's 1-0 Islanders on a beautiful power play goal. With a two-man advantage, Leach opens the scoring.
And they'll still have a one-man advantage after this is over. Boy, you figured, Gary, this to be a very critical moment in this early going.
Well, it was just a matter of time. The Flyers had good puck movement. The Islanders were trying to use that triangle, being the two men short. But if you have the good puck movement, you'll always be able to find somebody to clear. Actually, Ricky McLeish makes a pretty good pass there on his backhand. And Leach lets it go as soon as it hits his stick, and he gets right between the legs of Billy Smith. He does get part of it. Notice Smith moving back and forth, following the puck. McLeish has it right now. There's Leach right through the legs.
Time of the goal, 7:21. That's Leach, his ninth of the
playoff. McLeish and Barber get the assist at 7:21. Two-man advantage at the time. Now it's a one-man advantage. Putvan's penalty still in effect. Flyers with a 1-0 lead. Daly couldn't keep the puck in. Here comes a Philadelphia penalty to Holmgren, hitting Lane from behind and hauling him down. Holmgren will probably get a hooking penalty. Linsman and Lane talking things over. Now everybody arrives. The stick's coming up a bit. There's going to be a Philadelphia penalty out of all this as Linsman does some talking with Lauren Henning. Ron Finn steers him away.
Mr. Urban, I think we're going to be in for another long afternoon.
With the score, the Flyers won, the Islanders nothing. This is Stanley Cup 80.
Myers has signaled penalties again.
They're delay of game penalties.
Linsman and Bourne, they were yapping at each other.
Delay of game minors to Bourne of the Islanders, and there's Linsman joining Holmgren in the Flyer penalty box as Myers tries to keep control of things.
You know, Gary, there are penalties and there are penalties, but some of the cross-checking, the hooking, the holding we've seen here today has really been unnecessary considering the way the play has been going at that particular moment.
Dick, right now I think it's important for both teams to settle down, especially when it comes to take that bad penalty. We look at Dennis Potvin. There is the concern in his eyes. I think the picture tells it all. But the players can't afford to keep taking those, because then the power plays become a very important factor.
Each team has had 13 minutes in penalties already in the game. The Flyers are leading 1-0 on the goal by Reg Leach, his first of the final. Game with the Islanders two men short as Lauren Henning controls the puck. Starting slowly out, drops it back to Morrow. Lane, the other Islander on the ice, against Bridgman, Busnick, and Watson. This is Morrow coming in on goal. A high shot went off Peter's arm. Mike Busnick with the puck to Mel Bridgman. Bridgman one-on-one against Lane. Bridgman, a nice move, coming in on goal, a backhander. Smith stopped at the bouncing puck in front of the net. Morrow starts back. Bridgman checking him from behind. DuPont defending. A weak shot is stopped by Peters. Penalties have expired, at least one of the string of penalties. That's Potvans. He's back on the ice. Changes on the fly as Busnick steers it out with away from the play, Trotsky and Bridgman all tangled up. Now the Islanders have the advantage. Five against four, including goaltenders. Putvan with the puck, centering it, it's tipped away. The score, 1-0 Philadelphia, 9 minutes gone, first period. Right now the Flyers are two men short. The Islanders are one man short. Trotsky with the puck to Putvan. Ran into DuPont. Putvan hit by DuPont as Trotsky tried to center the puck. Bossy picked it up. Bossy to Potvin to Stefan Pearson. Centering it, blocked in front. DuPont steers the puck out while checked by Trotsky. Just 12 seconds left in the minors to Holmgren, Linsman, and Bourne. In goes Trotsky, passes. Bossy shoots, missed the net. May have tipped off Peters. Potvin from the point. Seconds remaining. Now the penalties are over. The teams are at full strength. It's still 1-0 Flyers. Battle for the puck. Daly, an arm lock on Trotsky. Out comes Linsman. Linsman and Holmgren. Linsman controlling the puck to allow the completion of a line change. Halfway through the first period, 1-0 Philadelphia. Linsman shoots. Smith had trouble with it, but it went off his arm. Potvin turning away from Brian Propp. This is Mike Bossy in on Watson. Watson took him out. Call for a penalty as the play went on. Now behind the play, penalty indicated, back of the net. Busnick holding on to Clark Gillies, back of the goal. And Bob Myers is really earning his dollar today. Busnick for holding at 10:15. There's Bob Nystrom. anxiously looking on after getting in a scrap with Kelly. He, of course, is still in the penalty box, but his minor's expired, his major's still in effect. Islanders trailing 1-0, have the man advantage. Of course, they're key power play players, but on the ice an awful lot early in the game. They're not out there right now as the play goes offside. They're using Wayne, Morrow, Gillies, Sutter, and Goring on the power play as you look at Bill Barber.
Now, Pat Quinn had a good view up in the seat back there, but you know, this morning Bill Barber felt that the key to the game tonight, or this afternoon, I'm going to say that so many times, but this afternoon was the first 10 minutes. There's Bill Barber. We have to keep the Islanders off the scoreboard and get a few, and so far they're in the right track.
9.5 minutes left, first period, 1-0 Philadelphia. Leach scoring the goal with the Islanders two men short at that time at 7:21. Right now the Flyers are one man short for another minute and 37 seconds. Now the Islanders have their keys point men out there with Potvin and Persson. Potvin patrolling the puck, flips it for Butch Goring. It went off the boards as Wilson goes to the puck. Ben Wilson scoops it right to Persson at the left point. Hands it right back to Wilson. This time he clears it down the ice. Islanders do look a little tight in this pressure-packed situation.
Jim, the Islanders haven't had a shot in the power play. They're not getting their shots like they were in other games.
Butch Goring, on his right is Sutter. On his left is Bourne. The shot right on. Peters stopping it, although it handcuffed him for a while, and he's having a little trouble getting up by the looks of it.
Pete Peters has been shaken up after making that last save. And is it his hand? Yes.
It's his hand there. Matt DiPaolo, the physiotherapist of the Flyers, is out there looking at it. You know, it seemed that when Goring shot that puck, it dropped. Now watch Peters go down. He's, as soon as the shot originates, and it may have hit him right under the blocker, there is an area that becomes very vulnerable out there, not much padding.
So Pete Peters getting set now as 1:03 remains in the penalty against the Flyers, Buznik. Peters was just exceptional two nights ago.
1-0 to score. Trocheck in front. Oh, he missed a great chance making those moves in front of the net. As it's still 1-0 Philadelphia, Brian Trocheck just failed to tie it. There's 52 seconds left in this Islander power play. Bob Bourne with the puck, moving in on Daly. Daly gets a piece of him, and Reg Leach gets the puck. Over to DuPont, clearing it out. Billy Smith comes out to get the rolling puck as Bobby Clark moves in to check. Stephen Pearson around to Mike Bossy. Finelli now with the puck. Moving it on Wilson. Finelli from the corner, centering it. Tipped away from Trocheck. A backhander, Wilson, the scramble, the puck is in, it's a goal. The Flyers will argue that it was put in with a high stick, but I think it was below the shoulder. The Flyers claim it's a high stick, but it's a 1-0.
We're gonna have an argument here, Jim. They're really crowding around Bob Myers. And we'll have to wait. The stick, not on the ice. We're trying to find out if it is a goal. Bob Myers has gone to the box. You see Barber, Watson, everybody over there arguing with him. The scoreboard reads Flyers and Islanders at one.
And Myers has
and
called
that
it a goal.
Tells it all.
Well, you knew there was going to be an argument there, and it is still going on, but you saw referee Myers point and said, I'm the one who makes the decision. So here we go, the old judge for yourself on the replay routine, Gary.
There, that shows the strength of Tinelli. Now right in front of the net. There's the stick.
Ooh.
Well, what do you think, Dick?
I don't know. I thought it looked a little high myself, but that was a quick look. We see Potvin properly here. Let's see.
Now let's see if we can pick it up any better from this angle. Dennis Potvin will come in from his defensive position. When he batted it, it may have been below, right at waist level.
It looked like the stick was above the shoulder on the replay, but Bob Myers has to make an instantaneous call, and he called it a Potvin goal from Bossy and Trocheck at 11:56 to tie it at one. Trocheck now with 28 points establishes a new Stanley Cup playoff record. One all tie. Bridgman trying to center the puck. Langevin coming out with it. Joined by number 11 Merrick and Tinelli. Weak shot handled by Peters. Scooping it to the corner. This is Langevin. Can't pick it up. It came off the board strangely to Mike Buznik. Rick McLeish lost it to Howitt. Howitt ducking away from the check. Shot went high as Merrick blasted it off the glass. Kick to Howitt. Overskating the puck. Busnick trying to get it to Al Hill. This is McLeish, one and one on Langevin. The wrist shot deflects to Billy Smith. 7 minutes left, first period. It's a one-all tie. Controversial goal by Potvin, tying it up. Tinelli. Bumped to the ice by Wilson. Keeps fishing for the puck. Lindsman now has it. Goring keeps after him. Now Jack McElhaughey, only his second shift of the period. Try to push it through, broken up by Lee. This is Clark Gillies trying to get in the clear. Wilson cutting him off. The shot, Peters stopped it. Great effort by Ben Wilson to get back and check Gillies. Otherwise, he would have had a clear-cut breakaway. But Wilson hurried him with his shot. Peters stopped it. It's still 1-0. Flyers have been caught two or three times today in this first period on line changes. Almost cost them a goal there. Great effort by Wilson getting back. Morrow can't keep the puck onside. Now to Gord Lane. Slapping it in. Ben Wilson controlling it for Philadelphia. To Brian Propp. To Ken Linsman. Checked at the line. This is Butch Goring. To Clark Gillies. Leach goes to check him. Goring with the puck. Centering it. Right in front. Sutter scores. Brian Sutter hit the roof. And it's 2-1. Islanders.
Well, there's a happy fellow. Look at him. Sutter. What a play. Watch his pass to Sutter breaking down the wing, and he makes no mistake. Got it right under the crossbar. Now talk about finding the open man. Clark Gillies drops the pass to Goring. Goring on his forehand, a perfect pass. Look at the net bulge in top, perfect shot. Peters had gone down and Sutter made no mistake.
So the controversial goal by Potvin, and it is controversial because by one angle, it looked like definitely his stick was over the shoulder. It counted to tie it, and look at Sutter. Started the year as a junior hockey player in Western Canada. Here he is in what could be a cup-clinching game, getting a big one for the Islanders.
Dick, that's when it becomes so important. You know, coaches stress this all the time, that from the blue line in, you better stay with your man. Don't let him go. There's a tendency for a player, he feels that once he hits the blue line, his job is over. It isn't over. You have to take that man right to the net. The Flyers were unable to do this, and Sutter gets a goal and a perfect feed by Goring.
I may have said the wrong Sutter boy. There's only seven of them playing hockey. There was Dwayne, who scored the goal from Gillies and Goring at 14:08. His third goal of the playoffs. Potvin's earlier goal was his sixth of the playoffs. 2-1 Islanders. Krejci with the puck. Centering it. Loose puck in front. Still loose. Sitting there for Reg Leach to take out of trouble. Covering it back of the net. Settle things down. Flyers, of course, with more playoff experience. Barber, the two Stanley Cup champs, taken out by Lorimer. No Islander player has ever been on a Stanley Cup champion. Seven Flyers have. Rick McLeish back to get the puck. 5 minutes left, first period. Islanders 2, Flyers 1. Bob Daly shoots high, hit the post, went way up in the seats. What a shot by Daly.
Well, what a shot by Bob Daly there. And that, you know, he was just one stride over the blue line, and I don't think Bill Smith saw that one at all. And right off the crossbar of the post and went high into the stand. As an excited Islander fan.
Excited, I think she's confused.
Doesn't matter how young. Boy, do those fingers ever taste good.
Smith was confused. Smith, I think, thought that was going wide. He just let it go. He was awfully lucky not to get caught that time. Crowd in an uproar.
Dick, it's very hot in this building, and it looks like the ice is soft. You'll notice the puck bouncing all over the place. So the teams, a lot of the times, will just dump it in and go in after that rather than try those passes.
4:52 left in the first period as Jim Watson goes back to get the puck. One of the Watson boys from Smithers failed to get the puck out. The battle in the corner. And it's covered up by Merrick and Watson. Stoppage in play. A little high sticking going on. Busnick and Nystrom. Bridgman arrives, and there they go again. Nystrom fought Kelly earlier. Now he wants somebody else.
Now Myers will not wait. He will call penalties right away, but you know, the Flyers have to take advantage of this line right here. Nystrom, Tinelli, and Merrick. They have been on for a lot of goals against, and so you have to take advantage of that. Nystrom 10, Merrick 10, and Tinelli 11 goals against. They're minus 11. So if the Flyers want to hit one area, it's against this line.
Bill Bridgman's the man Nystrom is upset with, vice versa. Gary, that play by Bridgman returned lean around. Almost made it 2-0. You might look back on that one because the Flyers at that point had the momentum in the early going, and that was the part that we talked about. So important to start the hockey game. But now in the latter stages of this first period, 2 goals for the Islanders, it's 2-1. So Bridgman and Nystrom in the box, both with 2 minutes now, likely for, I don't know what the call will be. Starts with Buznik and Nystrom. There's Bridgman, number 10. And he gets in on the act and then into the penalty box. Whoop. Bridgman gets 10. So they are both gone for 12 minutes.
And that's a good call by Bob Myers. Let both teams know that he's not going to take any guff out there. And if they persist on retaliating after the penalty or after a call is made, then he'll just send them to the penalty box and add on the additional 10 minutes, just like he did there.
That's 19 minutes in penalties against Nystrom so far. So through the first half of the hockey game, he is not going to be very involved in the play very much.
We've had 52 minutes in penalties now in the period as you look at Wayne Merrick from Sarnia, Ontario, and Ottawa Juniors, a first-round draft choice of the Blues originally. Wearing that specialized shield, there's Dwayne Sutter from Viking, Alberta, and Bobby Nystrom from Kamloops, British Columbia. Sutter serving the minor to Nystrom.
Is he a happy kid, that Sutter?
Can't wait to get back home to tell all those brothers all about it, including two others in the National Hockey League, the St. Louis and Chicago. 4.5 minutes left, first period. It's 2-1 Islanders. Langevin with the puck. Buznik watching him, taking him in the corner. The defenseman bumped together as Al Hill goes to the puck. Coming out for Philadelphia, joined by McLeish on his left. Hill moving in on Tinelli. Hill with the puck, centering it, and it's deflected away. Bob Daly with the puck, DuPont, the other defenseman. McLeish and Hill up front as the teams are 5 aside. McLeish shot deflects high off of Langevin, and it's up into the seats. National television coverage in the United States and Canada, coast to coast, the sixth game of the Stanley Cup Final. The Islanders lead 3 games to 2, and this game 2-1 as the shot by DuPont went wide. Bob Bourne with the puck, DuPont slashing at him, the puck into skates. Bob Daly picked it up, and the play is called for a delayed offside. Bob Bourne skates back to get in position for the faceoff.
There's no doubt that tradition is against the Flyers. Only once in history has a team been down 3-1 in a final series and come back to win, and that was the Toronto Maple Leafs in 1942. In that case, they were down 3-0. That's in a final series, so it hasn't happened since 1942. And Brian Trottier with his assist here this afternoon, now with 28 points, and that's a record.
Passing mark set earlier by Phil Esposito and Frank Mahovlich. Little rough stuff by DuPont on Bourne, and DuPont, I think, is going to come out of it with a penalty as he had Bourne along the boards. Loose DuPont probably will get the penalty, indicated holding by Myers.
Well, the Flyers, they just can't lose their cool right now, and right now, Dick, it looks like they are. That's not a very intelligent penalty for DuPont to take, and you know, he throughout his career, he's been guilty of taking that type of penalty, and with the Flyers already one behind, they certainly don't want to get too far behind, never be able to catch up. There you see DuPont, unnecessary.
You know, they seem to lose their cool, Gary, a bit on the controversial goal that was allowed, the Potvin play. And I think they've been uptight ever since. They have not had a decent scoring chance since then.
You know, two of the best in the league trying to prove to one another which is the best. You know, a lot of pride with those players. That's something about this game. When you leave, you want to be the best at your position, and there's two guys that want to prove that.
And there you are, two of the best. 3.5 minutes left in the period. 2-1 Islanders lead. Trottier to Pearson. Stephen Pearson shoots. Missed from the short side. Potvin goes to the puck, to Bossy. Islanders with the power play. Trottier's in front, the puck didn't get through, but Pearson keeps it onside. Cart watching him. Stephen Pearson to Potvin. Shoots high. Peters took it on the chest. Held it, stopping the play.
The same situation that the Flyers will use here when they're two men short and the Islanders one is work that triangle. That Potvin there had the shot. Clark was sliding out, but he got it a little bit too high, and nobody really in front of the net to get Peters a screening effort. But they'll play one up, sometimes two up, only one man back. It depends on how the Islanders move that puck, but it seems that they keep feeding Dennis Potvin.
Potvin, who scored that controversial goal, which one appeared to be a high stick that tied the game at one. Now it's 2-1 Islanders, and they have the man advantage in the Philadelphia zone. Another minute and 26 seconds. Hot, now Pearson with the puck. Trotche in front being worked over by Busnick. Mike Bossy to Potvin to Pearson. Centered it, went across in front. Potvin gets to the puck. The Clark fell, turning. Potvin shoots. Here, it's stopped by Peters. Now Propp and Sutter come out of the penalty box after serving Miners, but the Flyers still shorthanded. Deflection by Bossy went wide. This is Trotche from the side of the net. Puck bounces to Brian Propp, and it rolls outside the line. Islanders have the man advantage for another 49 seconds. Stefan Pearson bumped by Daly. Crowd yelling for a penalty every time there's a collision. Daly with the puck. Now Bill Barber in on Stefan Pearson. Backhander went off the target. Wayne Sutter's pass intercepted by Barber. Islanders get it back. Potvin. Goring and Gillies with him, but the play's broken up. Rick McLeish getting loose. Moving in on Lane. The shot. Smith took it on the chest. McLeish always dangerous. Two big goals in game five. 16 seconds left in the power plays. Butch Goring lost control of the puck. Hustles into check. Wilson with the puck, put it off the glass. Clark Gillies had trouble controlling it. Steered it to the inboards. McElhargy with the puck. Overskates. Sutter checking him. Now the Flyers are back at full strike. Peters made a great save on Clark Gillies. Right in front, Peters robbed Gillies. 1:27 left. First period, it's still 2-1 Islanders. It's tense. Very tense in the building here. You could cut it with a knife. It's at four. In goes Tonelli. Bumped by DuPont. Now at center, it's Holmgren, joined by Linsman. Linsman in over the line, knocked down by Lane. Holmgren's backhander in front. Propp scores! Brian Propp alone in front. There he is, and it's a 2-2 tie.
And there are a fair number of Philadelphia Flyer fans in here. One section over there especially. 2-2 hockey game, Gary.
Bad clearing by the Islanders, and you know they haven't been able to put any pressure since the Islanders scored their first goal, but they had possession there. Look at everybody around. Three, four players around Holmgren. Now who's back? Nobody's back. There is Propp, snuck behind Morrow, and had an easy time of it. What a big goal for Brian Propp, going into the dressing room with only 1:02 left. There you see it all. Now watch Propp just go behind. Everybody's watching the puck. Nobody's worrying about Brian Propp. It comes to him, he makes no mistake.
We're in the last minute of the first period. It's a 2-2 tie. Leach and Propp for the Flyers, Potvin and Sutter for the Islanders. Peters missing the puck. It's recovered by Propp in the corner. And they'll be cheering in Newdorf. It's in Saskatchewan. Brian Propp getting a big goal from Holmgren. And Linsman also gets an assist on the goal at 18:58. Benny Morrow with the puck. Peters again missed that puck back of the net, but the Flyers are able to control and get organized. Daly picking it up off the boards. 20 seconds left in the period. Park hustling in on Lorimer. And icing is called on Philadelphia. 16 seconds left in the period, so this is a key faceoff when they ever get lined up for it. Bobby Clark instructing Ben Wilson on what he plans to do against Trotche on the draw, or hopes to do at least. Battle for the puck, and the Flyers did manage to clear it out as Lorimer plays it off the boards for Mike Bossy. It's tipped outside the line as the seconds tick away. Peters handling the puck with 4 seconds left in the period. Leaves it for Wilson. They'll go into the dressing room all tied. In a rugged first period, and Peters, sure feeling the heat, goes to that dressing room in a 2-2 tie. Out of pressure on the officials, Bob Myers, his linesman Leon Stickland, Ron Finn. It's unfortunate that two goals are already controversial ones. Hot Vans appeared to be put in with a high stick, and you saw Sutter's goal on a play that was offside. We're starting the second period. The Islanders in the white, moving the puck. Flyers defending in their road uniforms, and an offside is called as Bob Bourne moved in ahead of Brian Trotche. Trotche used to play in a little group called Buzzin' the Boys. Around the dances at Val Marie.
Well, it's a long way from there to the National Hockey League Stanley Cup scoring record of 28 points, which he has established here this afternoon. 12 goals, 16 assists. Frank Mihalovic and Phil Esposito, the co-holders of that mark. Espo in 70, and Mihalovic tied it in 71, so it's been a long time, Jim.
Espo, of course, did it in fewer games than anyone. A remarkable playoff performance by Big Phil. Bob, now it's Barber with the puck to Reg Leach. Trying to get it to Bobby Clark, who hustles to the puck. Put it off the boards to Barber. Came back to the line and out. Bob Daly couldn't reach to keep onside, and if he can't reach, it's too far away. He's got the biggest reach in the league. Daly shooting the puck in. It's Lorimer with the puck, watched by Barber. Bourne couldn't take it off his skates. Now he gets another chance and brings it out. The score is 2-2. Bob Bourne in on DuPont. Takes a shot off the target, right in front as it went through the legs of Peters and came off the lively baseboards. Prop to Reggie Leach. His shot just ticked wide of the target and hit something on the way. Must have ticked off the arm of Billy Smith. Hard shooters all. Ryan Prop centering the puck. Holmgren's shot is stopped by Billy Smith, and he covers up the puck.
You know, it's interesting. Billy Smith seemed to freeze Gary. You mentioned it on a shot by Daly in the first period. That last one seemed to tick off the post, I thought, that beat him just before the play that ended the sequence.
That was the Reg Leach shot here. Hey, Smith comes out here to challenge. You notice he's out from his crease there and take the angle away from Paul Holmgren. That's why it's so important. Both coaches will stress that. Stand up at the blue line, guys. By golly, you let a man penetrate over that blue line, you're going to be in trouble.
Bob Nystrom in the penalty box sitting out his misconduct penalty along with Mel Bridgman.
2-2 tie as Nystrom looks on from the penalty box. There's the faceoff lineup in the Islanders zone. Linsman against Goring, and Goring won the draw. Gord Lane with the puck. Lane and Morrow, the Islander defense. Puck flipped away from Wilson. Play a bit ragged here at the start of the second period. I think they're all feeling the pressure of the moment.
You know, they say that Kenny Linsman stirs things up, Gary. He starts things and then kind of disappears.
What he tries to do is agitate. You know, if you've got a key player in another team and Linsman's out there, he'll bother him, he'll talk to him, he'll jab him. And then when it comes time to meet head on, he'll say, well, Paul, it's all yours. Talking to about Paul Holmgren. He's his protector out there.
McElhargy going to the puck. Checked by Goring, tying him up. Sutter joins them, cover up the puck. Now watch Linsman and Sutter. So they'll stir it up a bit. McElhargy hit Sutter. You just knew that was going to happen when Linsman arrived there.
That's called gamesmanship.
Right. McElhargy and Sutter also involved. Now we're ready to start hockey again. A minute and a half gone. Second period. 2-2 tie. Lane pumped Holmgren. Puck is shot into the corner. Wilson goes to the puck. Goring goes in to check. Played around to the board. Sutter couldn't quite control it. Comes around to Brian Propp. Ran into Morrow. Art Gillies filling back for the defenseman, gets the puck. Gillies taking it in. Lost control. Propp dumps it out. Holmgren looking for Linsman. Linsman goes to the puck. Moving in on Morrow. Shot missed along the ice. Smith kicked at it, but was off the target. Lane. Oh, was he bumped by Linsman. Big Gord Lane. He was looking for Holmgren to hit him, and Linsman came along and did the job.
Well, as small as he is, he still gets involved, and that's why you have to respect the little guy. And fans love him in Philadelphia. He makes things happen out there. You know, with the score tied, you wonder how big that next goal is going to be. The Flyers, they would love to get ahead to see how the Islanders will react. There's the box. Continually, players will give each other a lift, get each other going on that bench. A big, big important factor, the communication, the enthusiasm that you have behind the bench and on the bench there with coach and player.
Rick McLeish waiting on the faceoff against Wayne Merrick. 2-2 tie, Flyers with the puck. That's Buznik in the corner, bumped by Langevin. They keep fighting for the puck. Merrick goes to it. It hit Hale, bounces in front. McLeish just failed to control it. Stefan Persson behind the net for Langevin. Both teams having problems handling the puck for a variety of reasons. The good forechecking is part of it. The sawdust coming out of the end of the sticks is another part of it, perhaps.
And a little bit of nerves, too. Stefan Persson, I thought, was the outstanding Islander in Game 5 on Thursday night at the Spectrum. He has had as much trouble handling the puck tonight as Jim, as anybody else has. Today, I said tonight, that's number first for me.
You know, both teams are playing similar in style. They're sending the puck in there and getting two men on it. But the important factor is to have that man deep in the slot. One guy, in case possession is lost, to be able to come back. And then defense on both teams are pinching in, try to cause a giveaway.
Both teams very evenly matched, similar in style. As Langevin comes out with the puck, misses a check from Buznik. Shot the puck in. Jim Watson goes after it. In goes Merrick to bump him, but Watson cleared the puck around on the board. Steered to the line and out. This is McLeish just failing to get loose. And he had John Paddock on his right. Number 12 is Paddock. I believe this is his first shift for the Flyers. With Gorenz injured, Paddock is getting a chance to play. Jim Watson with the puck. Al Hill on his left. The shot's missed. Stopped it. Langevin from behind the net. 3 minutes gone, second period, 2-2 tie, sixth game for the Cup. Puck is shot into Flyer territory. Howitt centering it. This is Persson shooting through the crowd and went off the target. Peters covers up the puck. Came loose, but the whistle blew. As Pennelly is pushed around, oh, look at the high sticking going on. Something's going to come here. Howitt is number 8. Jimmy Watson behind him. Ron Finn, the linesman, trying to get Howitt out of there. Cool him off.
In a while, Gary, since a potential cup-clinching game has featured this sort of thing. Usually the teams stick to their knitting at times like that.
Howitt says, who me? Bob Myers is going to give him a penalty, perhaps an additional penalty, but certainly Howitt. Miners to Watson and Howitt, 31 minutes to Philadelphia, 27 to the Islanders. It's a 2-2 tie. Clark's pass tipped away by Bourne. Puck is cleared to center. Potvin in possession. Potvin and Lorimer on the Islander defense. Bourne and Trotsky up front. Bourne to Trotsky. To Bourne. His pass is tipped away. Leach coming back. Leach, Clark, Daly, and DuPont are on the ice for Philadelphia. Clark tried to go through. Play broken up. Three Islanders back. Potvin with the puck. Potvin to the corner. DuPont after him. He knew the collision was coming. Potvin coming in front. A shot deflects wide. Clark Gillies just on the ice, tried to put it in front, and DuPont intercepts. Gillies keeps after him. Puck kept in. Gillies and Daly, two big guys. The crowd love it. Bobby Clark with the puck, slashed by Gillies, keeps turning. Reg Leach on his right is Daly. There's the pass to Daly. Poke checked away. Butch Goring, excellent skater, a lot of moves. Lane had trouble controlling. Put it in front, it went around on the board. This is Lorimer, a shot, blocked. Goring taken to the ice by Clark. Puck came loose. DuPont has it. Big man from Three Rivers, Quebec, to Ridge Leach. Getting away from Lane, moving in on Lorimer. Leach shoots, whistling it high. Puck, he scored one goal today in this 2-2 tie. Goring. Sutter's on his left, so he leaves him the puck. Goring at the end of a long shift. Now we'll get to the bench. 5 minutes gone, second period, 2-2 tie. Islanders lead 3-2. Will it go to 7 Tuesday in Philadelphia? We'll know at the end of this hot afternoon. Barber with the puck. Being well checked by Morrow. Sutter. Lost it to McLeish. Howitt and Watson back on. Watson with the puck. Teams at full strength. This pass tipped away. Watson goes to the puck again. Jimmy Watson. Bumped by Morrow. Watson has that tender shoulder. Every hit must hurt. Barber checked by Morrow. Took him off the puck. Buznik from the corner. Lane tried to tie him up. Big battle for the puck. Barber back at the goal. Morrow pins him. The puck is finally held to stop the play. Ken Linsman and Wayne Merrick will face off. Leon Stickle drops the puck. Pop goes after. Battle back of the net. Linsman has the puck, centered it. It's steered away, high to the board. Still in Islander territory. Linsman's pass intercepted by Persson. Stefan Persson for John Tinelli. He's out there with Merrick and Bourne. Tinelli brings it in. Tripped up by Watson. Lindsman with the puck. Interference on Tinelli. Out comes Lindsman with the puck. Tinelli couldn't get to him. Big Paul Holmgren. The play goes offside as he had trouble controlling the puck. As Lindsman and Goring face off. Lindsman is centering number 26, prop number 17, Holmgren. As the puck is dumped in by Watson. And right away, the Flyers make a defensive change. Watson and Busnick leave, replaced by McElhargy and Wilson. Wayne Sutter, the Clark Gillies, taken to the ice by Wilson, and Wilson will get a penalty for hauling down Clark Gillies, and Big Ben goes to the penalty box, and the crowd comes to life. Their power play has scored 14 goals in the series in 36 opportunities. The score is 2-2. 6:39 was the time of Wilson's penalty. Stephen Pearson with the puck. Intercepted by Bob Daly, dumping it in. Setting up the Islander power play. That's Potvin going to the puck. Number five with him is Pearson. Up front, 14 Bourne. 19 Trotsky with the puck. On the right, 22 Bossy. Puck went around on the boards. Kept into the corner to Trotsky. Potvin's waiting deep in the slot. Stephen Pearson from the point. To Bourne. To Bossy in front. Couldn't finesse it by Pete Peters. Stephen Pearson. Shot. Knocked down in front. A scramble in front. Puck steered to the boards. Dupont. Nailing Pearson. The puck control by the Islanders. Bourne's weak shot. Backhander. They score. Ryan. Or it's Bossy. Mike Bossy. 3-2 Islanders.
Circling in the slot, gets the shot away from DuPont. Peters not able to move, and that could be an awfully big goal. The congratulations on the bench, the excitement by the players. Who says emotion doesn't play a big part in professional sports? There's a good example.
There's my kind of girl, Miss Piggy.
The Islanders continue to capitalize on the power play.
Well, the announcement goes up on the goal for Bossy. He now has at least 1 point in 13 of the 16 games he's played into the playoffs. That's his 10th point in the final round. Make that his 11th point, and the record for a final series is 12. So, along with Trotsky, he could end up in the record book when this one's all over.
He didn't have one of his best series against Buffalo. In fact, in a few games, didn't look like he was out there, but he's come back with reckless abandon and proven the superstar that he is to be able to get the clutch goal, and this was a clutch goal.
The assists are announced Trottier and Bourne, although we thought Stephen Pearson perhaps deserved an assist. And they might change that, but it's Bossy's goal. It makes it 3-2 Islanders. Busnick to the puck. Checked on the inboards by Merrick. The crowd came alive when the Islanders went on the power play. An example of the crowd turning on the players, igniting the Islanders as their potent power play went to work. Although a fan shot contributed to the goal, and Bossy makes it 3-2 New York. Mel Bridgman with the puck. To Al Haleman off his skate. Merrick. Tinelli on his right. 3-2 Islanders, just past the 8-minute mark, second period. 3-2 is also the score in the series. New York with the lead. Will they win the cup today? Mel Bridgman to Al Hill. A shot went high. McLeish. Shot by Wilson in the crowd is blocked. Tinelli trying to get loose. McElhargy checking him, hauls him down. There will be a penalty to Jack McElhargy. He knows it. He doesn't like it. A great competitor that he is, but he's going to get 2 minutes.
Well, there they go again. A Flyer heading to the penalty box.
And there's the potential breakaway by the Islanders and the hook coming up. No question about that. Another example, if you're skating, the team can't catch you. They usually end up with a penalty.
Pennelly was the player hauled down by McElhargy as Potvin passes to Pearson. Islanders with a man advantage. 3-2 lead. Krejci from behind the net to Bourne. Now Potvin from the point puts it in front. Tipped away from Bossy. Barber dumped it out. Bridgman going after Potvin as they race for the puck. Collision coming up, but no, well, it was a sidestep by Potvin, and Bridgman hit the end boards. Not too often these players miss body checks. They're both the style that play the man. And they're in the Stanley Cup final. Offside called at the Philadelphia blue line.
Well, one thing that the Islanders have to be aware of certainly is the power, the shorthanded situation, the shorthanded goals that the Flyers have a tendency to do. You know, they don't wait. If they get an opportunity to go, away they go. They don't just ice the puck. And a lot of times you catch a team off guard because they don't expect you to go. The Flyers, they've always played that way. Even when we're a man short, the likes of Leach, Clark, McLeish, go.
Reg Leach, who had four shorthanded goals during the regular season. Pride of Riverton, Manitoba, looking up at the clock with 1:19 left in the penalty to McElhargy. There's the time left in the second period as we're nearing the midway mark of the second period. New York leading 3-2. Two all after one. Reg Leach unloads a shot. Hit the crossbar. Smith thought it was in. It hit the goaltender's stick. Hit the crossbar, but it stayed out. And you could see for a moment, Billy Smith sagged. He thought it was a goal. The puck is cleared down the ice by the Flyers, who almost got a shorthanded goal. We just talk about Leach being the threat. Gary Gornhaber, you're a genius. He almost tied it up. What a shot. Smith thought he was beaten. This is Sutter. Peters made the save and held the puck standing up well against Sutter. Sutter now squaring off with Watson. So much feeling, so much heat in the building and on the ice. Gillies intercepts Buznik.
You talk about Clark Gillies being a baseball player, Jim. He would have been a pretty good offensive guard in football. The way he ran interference at the Philadelphia blue line to spring that left side open, he took out two Flyers.
That certainly paved the way, didn't it?
Peters made the save.
Well, if you can get away with that, you're going to do
it.
Look
at, there he is.
Oh, home free Sutter. But Peters, oh boy, does he play that good. Challenges. Sutter never had a thing to shoot at. But on the other end, and Billy Smith continues to have trouble on those long shots. He got a piece of it, but it hit the crossbar. And that's about the fourth time this afternoon where he's really juggled a long shot.
What a blast by Leach on Billy Smith, who today is in his 20th NHL game. He's supposed to light that thing, fella. He's just going to chew that big cigar.
You know, you watch what happens here, Jim. A lot of times when the Flyers are killing a penalty, as soon as their defense get possession, who's ever out there, the winger, the centerman, will go to the boards. If it comes around the right side, the other wing will automatically cut into the center. That'll create an opening, and that's the way they try to do it, the Flyers, to take advantage of perhaps the Islanders not taking him serious out there. They're going to shoot it down to get those shorthanded goals.
Mark Petrace on this faceoff. 44 seconds left in McElhargy's penalty. Puck tipped in by Stefan Pearson. Petrace from the corner. Lost it to Mike Buznik. Jim Watson goes to the puck. Bossy checking him. Leach gets the puck out. Now there's 30 seconds left in McElhargy's penalty. Hot van for the puck. Three times winner of the top defenseman of the league award, Denny Potvin. Bourne centering it and went behind the net. Bourne tried to jam it. It went into Peter's skates. He didn't see it, but he stopped it. Bridgman joined by Barber. 10 seconds left in the penalty. This is Barber. Just failed to get loose. Mike Bossy. Now Krejci to Bourne. The penalty's over. Flyers at full strength. Krejci behind the net. Put it to the corner. Bourne and Bridgman after it. Bridgman wins the fight for the puck. Still 3-2 Islanders, 9 minutes left, second period. Krejci turning with the puck, checked by Bill Barber. Morrow, an Olympic gold medal in Lake Placid, maybe a Stanley Cup here, as we have penalties to Bridgman and Bossy. And now everybody arrives. They had an exchange on the boards. Of course, Bridgman is no stranger to the penalty box, but Bossy seldom sees it.
Well, Bossy has certainly become a factor in scoring goals, and Bridgman trying to work him over a little bit. Now watch Bridgman here, give him the once-over, and throw the gloves in his face. And Bossy, with a little hook there, will get the penalty. So there, both teams will play a man short.
Flyers have now had 37 minutes in penalties. The Islanders, 29 minutes. Teams five aside, 8:42 left now in the second period. The score, 3-2 for New York. Butcher shot in by Holmgren, bounces back out to Ben Wilson, chased by Nystrom. Nystrom stealing the puck, cutting it on goal. Tried to put it in as Peter sprawled, and the puck was kept out. We had to stand to see that as the crowd stands and they're excited here in the Nassau Coliseum today, but why not? Lauren Henning is seeing limited ice time today to Nystrom. Over to Lane, a shot, missed the net. Morrow shot, deflects wide. Wilson from the corner puts it off the boards, not out. Morrow moving in, he shoots. Peter stopped it, covers up the rebound.
Excellent shift here. Nystrom against Ben Wilson. Wilson took a little too nonchalant, and Nystrom with his strength broke right in. And watch this, and the cut into the net. Peters had to be particularly sharp. But even in this play here, Nystrom had a chance to put in the rebound, just wasn't able to reach it.
It seems right now, Dick, that the Islanders are much stronger than the Flyers and are really taking it to them.
I'm wondering, Gary, there's no doubt as far as the Flyers are concerned, the spirit is willing, but I'm wondering if the flesh is just getting a little too weak for them to come back all the way.
With our pressure here, Peters will come up with the save. Well, it continues, and then he comes up with a save to stop play, but the Islanders are on the go.
Good effort by Nystrom on that shift. There's 52 seconds left in minor penalties to Bossy and Bridgman. Icing indicated on Philadelphia, and it is called as Lorimer got back to the puck.
Gary, the Islanders skating is paying off with Bossy in the penalty box along with Bridgman. That extra room, the five against five, we saw them earlier on. That's when they seem to excel.
When you usually get your speedster out, they have that ice surface to work with, more room out there. That's why you'll see a Bourne or a Goring, a McLeish, or a Linsman out there. They're the game breakers.
Shot by Langevin is held by Peters. I'm Jim Robson with Gary Dornhofer, Dick Irvin, and the Hockey Night in Canada crew. And a hot afternoon at Long Island as young Pete Peters, a 22-year-old from Edmonton, knows all about Stanley Cup pressure now.
Well, for the goaltenders, the hardest position to play. You know, if they let in a bad goal, it's amazing how the rest of the team will sag. They know the important role they have out here. It's important to come up with a big save to keep their team in it. Time and time again, when that bad goal goes in, I think it affects everybody sitting on the bench.
Clark and Trotsky continue their battle of the faceoff, as it's been all through the final. Two of the best in a key part of the game. Who won this one? Trotsky did. Lorimer shoots right on. Peters held it again.
Peters hoping to become the first rookie goaltender to win a Stanley Cup since Ken Dryden did it in 1971.
Watch Trotsky after he gets the puck back, how he heads for the net, trying to cause the interference. Got the draw
again. Islanders win the draw. Lorimer shoots, and again Peters stops the shot. Moose DuPont with the puck to Bobby Clark, moving in on Lorimer. Clark making moves, didn't get knocked down, but he lost control of the puck as Bourne came back to help out. Leach from the corner. Andre DuPont shot, deflects wide. Trotsky to the puck, steers it down the ice. Icing indicated on the Islanders. DuPont to the puck. There's the icing to stop the play.
7 minutes left in the second period, 10 seconds remaining in the Bossy-Bridgman penalties. Bob Lorimer heads back. He and Denny Potvin paired. Not a bad way to come into the first big pressure situation of a playoff, Gary, with Denny Potvin on your left side. But as we talk now, Al Arbor makes a change with Langevin and Hirson taking over.
There's Al Arbor, 47 years of age, from Sudbury. He was on three Stanley Cup winners as a player.
Detroit in 54, Toronto in 62 and 64.
Played 12 years in the National League, now in his ninth year as a coach. Mike Busnick unloads a shot into the midsection of Billy Smith.
You know, Al was also in the finals three times with the St. Louis Blues as a player, 68, 69, and 70. So he knows what the boys are going through out in the ice.
You know, in the faceoffs, it's so very important for the wingers especially to anticipate the drop of the puck and get out there. Wilson becomes a threat in that slot area on the draw.
Battle for the puck, a quick first shot just went wide. And now the penalties to Bossy and Bridgman are up as you see them come back into play. Busnick gambles, moving to the puck. This is Bossy, but the puck got away from him, and Ben Wilson is there to take control. Long pass, deflects away. Trotsky with Nystrom on his left. The pass misses Nystrom. McLeish checked off the puck. Battle between Busnick and Nystrom. Busnick with the puck. Hands it away. Tinelli put it behind the net and goes to it. Centering it, Nystrom fanned on it. Lauren Henning backhanding it off the boards. Nystrom battling for the puck. Try to come in front. Tinelli try to get it to Nystrom. Henning has replaced Merrick on this line at least the last couple of shifts. Centering Nystrom and Tinelli. 5:57 left, second period. 3-2 for New York Islanders. They lead the series 3-2. Langevin to the puck. Banks it on the boards to Nystrom. DuPont goes to him. Turns as Nystrom put it in front. Smith or Peters steered it behind the net. Young Brian props. And there's going to be a penalty to Tinelli. And DuPont also gets involved. They're at center ice with their sticks a little high. Tinelli. DuPont is trying to get to him, and the linesman won't let them. Ron Finn trying to cool off Moose DuPont, who's rapidly gaining on an old teammate, Dave Schultz, for penalty minutes in the playoffs.
Well, DuPont hooked Tinelli on the way by him, and then Tinelli retaliated with a slash, so Myers, he got them both off of there. DuPont very upset, and he's giving his opinion.
Glad we can't hear it right now. There's an extra two. You heard a voice there. It'll be Bob Myers telling the official scores.
So DuPont draws an extra two.
And the Flyers continue to take the bad penalties and put themselves in an awkward position. You know, you wonder when they're going to take stock and realize what is happening out here, that you just can't continually spend that time in the penalty box the way the Islanders play the power play.
Gary, that's, I don't know, you hate to say this, lack of discipline, mental discipline or whatever. I'm sure that Coach Quinn doesn't advocate this kind of thing. And it's just a breakdown on the part of the players. They have got to wisen up, my goodness.
Well, individually, Dick, I know a lot of times it's Coach Shiro, when you got a bad penalty, he just lets you sit for a period or so until you realize what was happening. You know, that's an individual thing. You have to use some good judgment. And if you can't catch a player, the easiest thing to do is let him go and get the next one. But players are not doing that.
Flyers have had 41 minutes in penalties now. The Islanders, 31 minutes. Right now, they're five aside for the next 2 minutes. Still a tight 3-2 score. New York leading. Lane with the puck. Hurried by Holmgren. Holmgren steals the puck momentarily, checked by Lane, and Morrow turns with the puck. Lindsman goes after him. A nice move by Morrow. The rookie passed and evaded Nystrom. Puck slides loose to Wilson. Puts it off the boards to Holmgren. Now Lindsman will race in after it. As Billy Smith taps it to Morrow, put it to the corner. Holmgren and Lane collide, and Lauren Henning goes to the puck. Henning getting a lot of ice time now. Nystrom in on Wilson. Nystrom for the net. Came in front. Oh, he ran into Peters. Knocked him down. Someone will go to Nystrom now. You can be sure of that. There's the hit by Lindsman. I knew it would happen. Lindsman hit Nystrom in behind after he had decked the goaltender, which is not surprising. You would expect something like that. Nystrom, who's been so much involved today, it was Lindsman who came in and hit Nystrom after Wilson had gone towards Nystrom. That's Peters in the net.
Peters is still down. Matt DiPaolo is down there looking at him. That was quite a collision. Hey, Lindsman is hunched over. I'd say there's no reason for that.
McElhargy pointing to the stands. I think they might be having some trouble with fans over there.
Some of the fans, there are some fans coming down the steps, excuse me, Jim, menacingly toward the Flyers bench. Well, here's how it all started with the rush by Nystrom, which carried him into the goal crease, flattened the goaltender, and then the non-fun began after that.
Well, Nystrom was trying to get out of the way, and it certainly was a vulnerable position for Peters to be. Where could he go? He couldn't go anywhere. Phil Mir is out there now beside Pete Peters, checking to see if he's all right. Watch. Nystrom trying to get out of the way, but he didn't have anywhere to go. Peters was in the way, and they collided. Wilson is going after Nystrom, and there comes Lindsman from behind and give him a shot.
So Lindsman and Potvin draw the penalties. Lindsman for his charge on Nystrom, Potvin for his charge on Lindsman. 3-2, the score, 4:51 left, second period. The Islanders in the lead.
Checking on Peters, who drew some applause here in the building, getting to his feet. 4:51 left, second period. It's 3-2 Islanders. Lindsman and Potvin getting minor penalties. And Peters' record in the playoffs, just posted there. But you know, in the regular season, he won 29, lost only 5, and tied 5. Oceanside, New York, loves Pearson and Trotsky. Kevin Lamb is now famous with a USC sweater, coast to coast.
Sending out Rick McLeish. He was the dominant force in game number 5. You really have to be aware of him when he gets to the blue line. He likes to cut to the center of the ice, to the right, then cut in the center and let that shot go. I feel the Islanders have made a good adjustment. They're prepared for that play, and when he does make his cut, they try to get the defenseman just to deflect the shot in the stands. He hasn't had one good shot today.
Leach and Goring on this faceoff. Buznik is 28, putting the puck behind the net for Jack McElhargy. McElhargy, Buznik, and McLeish on the ice for the Flyers. Rick McLeish, that's Buznik on his right. McLeish setting it up. Took the shot, blocked by Langevin. McLeish with the puck again on the line. McElhargy hustling to it. Took a check from Lorimer. Puck came loose. Goring to the corner, tied up by McLeish. Lorimer joins them. Langevin back of the net. In St. Paul, Minnesota. Dave Langevin, formerly with Edmonton when they were in the WHA, shooting the puck in, bouncing out of the corner, and that was Lorimer going for the net, and in the collision with McElhargy, he couldn't get a shot. Mike Buznik coming up with Rick McLeish. Buznik with some room. Langevin took him off the puck. Teams are playing four side, all kinds of room to skate. Goring joined by Langevin. Langevin and Wilson with the puck. Seems looking tired. Quick shot deflects high. Taken by Trotsky, just came on the ice. Now Tinelli coming out of the penalty box. So at this stage, the Islanders have a brief power play. 5-4. As we have a series of overlapping penalties. Crowd granting more goals with a 3-2 Islander lead. Morrow going for the front of the net, a shot just missed the far corner. Lane passing. Bossy took a check from Daly and the puck wound up in the seats.
Now reviewing the penalty situations, Denny Potvin looking up at the clock. He has 18 seconds to serve. So does Ken Lindsman, while Bruce DuPont will be in the penalty box after they leave. He has a minute 31 left in his penalty right now, so he'll be in there for a minute 13 after the other two come out, all other things being equal, which you can't predict in this game.
Peters looks a little shaken up there. Gary keeps looking for a little rest when there's a stoppage in play. I'm sure the tremendous heat on the ice would be a factor.
Well, as we keep going, especially in this third period, you know, the conditioning, Flyers have always had a history, especially this year, of being strong in that third period, and that's through the conditioning that they go through the season. Matt DiPaolo was very responsible for that.
This is the 110th game of the long season for these two clubs, including preseason, league, and playoff. Gord Lane to Stephen Pearson. Daly blocked the pass. Bobby Clark hustling to join him. Clark going in on goal. Smith kicked it out. Bobby Clark almost tied it. Trache in on Wilson, joined by Potvin in front. Couldn't reach the pass. Potvin controlling the puck on the boards. Stephen Pearson's pass. Mike Bossy's shot. Hit a skate. Wilson back of the net, beaten to the puck. A jam up at the side of the goal. Pete Peters has got that puck under his left hand. There it is.
Your attention, please.
Well, they settle down after that exchange, and to sort things out, the only person left in the penalty box right now is Moose Dupont, with 54 seconds left in his penalty. As you see, a mock-up of the Stanley Cup somewhere in this crowd. Boy, are they having fun in this building this afternoon. It's really something.
The next 54 seconds are very critical to both teams. From the Islanders' standpoint, they are to capitalize on this power play to go into that dressing room with a two-goal lead. It would be a big lift for the Flyers. You'd only be one goal behind with one period to play. They'd still be in this hockey game. So they need a good effort for the penalty killers.
That is the time left at DuPont's. Double minor, 54 seconds. Trache with the puck. And Potvin couldn't keep it onside. Number five is Potvin. Number seven taking the pass is Pearson. Number 22 with the puck now is Bossy. Other men on the power play, 14 Bourne, 19 Trache. Bourne with the puck. Shot. Peter stopped it. Where is it? Somewhere underneath that goaltender. He's got it by the post. You'll get a look at it. Pete Peters, a little slow getting up.
He's more than just a little slow getting up right here. He seems to be in a lot of trouble. Just now hauling himself up to his feet, really.
I'm sure Pat Quinn is watching him very closely. Here's the power play where the Islanders, a good chance here by Bobby Bourne. On the short side, Peter's having trouble picking it up. Finally sits down and is right on top of it.
2:10 left, second period, as Bourne talks to Howard at the Islander bench. Goring tried to get a shot, couldn't. Kept in by Pearson. To Dwayne Sutter. Knocked out of the air by Barber. Still in Flyer territory now, out. Goring with the puck. 18 seconds left in DuPont's penalty. The score is 3-2 for the Islanders. Anybody's game, anybody's series. Dennis Potvin rushing. Time for this late rush, but they're offside. 5 seconds left in DuPont's penalty. Philadelphia Flyers. We're in the final period in a 4-2 hockey game. The Islanders leading. The Flyers coming out. Bill Barber with the puck. His shot deflects high. Goes in among the spectators.
Well, I see a sign as we look at Billy Barber by an Islander fan. 60 minutes of hard work and the Stanley Cup is ours. Well, for the New York Islanders, it's only 20 minutes. And there's one guy that wants to have something to say about that. And been around the Flyers and watched them play too many times to throw in the towel. They're going to go out and work, but there's the sign.
Well, you know, there are other signs around here. Today's the day, finally.
Well, the Flyers are going to have to put some pressure on the Islanders and get some good scoring chances. 12 shots is certainly not enough. For the Islanders, you look for them to make short shifts. You look for them to make good line changes and not to get caught and give the Flyers the opportunity of getting back in this hockey game. I'm sure they've talked about it in the dressing room, and Al Arbor has mentioned it.
Trache and Clark continue their duel in the faceoff circle, well, this time inside the blue line, this faceoff location. They battle for the puck. It comes out into the neutral zone. Mike Buznik with the puck. Ben Wilson, Bobby Clark, who's out there with Bob Kelly now on the left side, and Reggie Leach. Kelly hasn't had much ice time. Buznik trying to put it in front. Clark controlling the puck on the boards, checked off it. Keeps battling for it, digs it out, dumps it into the corner for Leach. Float up by Lorimer, Potvin with the puck. Bumped by Clark, puck comes to center. 1 minute gone, third period. Islanders 4, Flyers 2. Kelly kicks the puck loose to Ben Wilson. Leach in there with him, goes in offside.
Well, I think for the Islanders standpoint here, one thing they don't want to do is sit on that lead as we look at Blaine Sutter, big goal in tonight's hockey game. You know, you keep letting a team come to you, and before you know, the game is tied. So the Islanders have to go to the offense as long as they have that one man back protecting in case the Flyers break out.
Lindsman and Goring, the rival centers on the faceoff. Morrow with the puck. DuPont tied up by Goring. They'll stop the play. There'll be a lot of play stoppages, don't you think, in this third period?
Just thinking that, Jim. Fellas like Butch Goring are going to be hanging out. Cute story. After the third game of the series here, I was talking with Butch in the dressing room. He was a star that night. His father's here. I told him he was picked a star. He said, no, I didn't deserve a star the way I played tonight. And his father said, oh, yes, you did, Butch. You played good.
Butch, 10 years with the Los Angeles Kings. Lindsman tried to center the puck, took a whack at it. It bounces to the corner. Sutter tried to dig it out. Holmgren centering it for Propp. Daly hustles to the puck. Put it behind the net for Lindsman. Propp's weak shot on a broken stick, and the shot went wide. Propp's stick went flying. Daly to Holmgren. To Lindsman. Holmgren goes in front. Daly from the point. He scores! Bob Daly, and it's 4-3 Islanders.
There's the early goal, Gary. A minute and 47 seconds worth of time in this third period, and the Flyers have moved to within one. There's Keith Allen and Ed Snyder at the bottom of your screen as they celebrate. And it's a little bit closer.
Well, they're out working the Islanders, and they're getting the shots through. Clark Gillies was just not able to get back in time, and Daly let one go, and that's the long shot that we're talking about that beat Billy Smith to the far side. Nobody in front. He wasn't screened on the play. It just overpowered him.
His fourth of the playoffs.
Daly got the goal. Good passes by Lindsman out of the corner and Holmgren from behind the net. They get the assists. 4-3. Now you'll feel the tension. Hope you're enjoying it at home, wherever you are. 147, Daly's goal. Henning tied up on the boards. We haven't seen Merrick. There's a chance for Nystrom, and Peter stopped the puck. He looked behind him and covered up the puck.
Bob Nystrom of the Islanders had a chance and scored on it, Gary, under tougher checking conditions late in the second, and now look at this chance here.
Well, he was all alone, just didn't get good wood at it. I think Bridgman partially deflected the shot and slowed it down, so Peters make the save.
Bridgman with the puck, dumping it in as he's knocked down by Langevin. Nystrom to the puck. Al Hill bumps in. Patrice joins them. Puck came loose. Wilson tried to keep it in. It's kept in. Rick McLeish winding up. Missed the net with a shot. Al Hill from the corner. Stephen Pearson to Bob Nystrom. Got it outside the line and just outside the line. Al Hill dumps it in. Heads to the bench as the Flyers make a line change. 3 minutes gone. Third period. It's 4-3 Islanders. Bob Nystrom in with Henning and Tonelli. From the corner, Henning. Shot hit a leg. Henning on the inboard, centered it. Intercepted. Stolen by Tonelli. Daly checking him. Barber has the puck. Out there with Bridgman. Bridgman, the captain of the Flyers. There's a penalty to Nystrom behind the play. He tripped Barber. Nystrom, a hero 1 minute, now goes to the penalty box.
Bob Nystrom of the Islanders in the penalty box, holding at 3:20. Gary, the Flyers couldn't have written this one better if they had done the script themselves.
Yeah, don't go away, folks. A lot of life left in the Flyers. There's the penalty coming up. Barber going down on Nystrom, trying to catch him from behind. And never get a better opportunity. Could have this game tied before 15 or 5 minutes are played in this third period.
Flyers trail 4-3 of the man advantage. 16 is Clark, 27 is Leach, 15 is Hill. On the point, 7 Barber, number 2 Bob Daly. Potvin with the puck, on defense with Lorimer for the Islanders. Clark just failed to knock it down. Penalty killers up front for New York. Number 19 is Trottier. Number 14 is Bourne. Clark. The Barber. Hit by Lorimer. Puck still in play. Still in play, says Bob Meyer. Keep playing it, he says. Now he stops the play.
And that's what the Islanders want to have happen. Hang on, kill some time. 28 seconds gone in the penalty. Well, there are two gentlemen who used to sign those mammoth paychecks Gary Dornhofer used to collect from the Philadelphia Flyers. Ed Snyder, the team's owner, Keith Allen, the general manager.
I didn't even put a dent in the payroll. Anyway, the Flyers will continue to move that puck around. They got the guys that can shoot it. Leach, he broke open a scoring slump that he was in. And Daly, of course, he has that low shot. Try to feed him and get somebody in front. That's always the key.
That Quinn looks so cool at the bench. He is. He's the only cool person in the building. Hot Van with the puck. Actually, there's a lot of coolness being shown on the ice. In a tension-packed sixth game of the Stanley Cup Final. A minute and 18 seconds left in the power play. Lorimer with the puck. Daly kept it in. Hot Van with the puck. Hot Van gets it out. Park and Henning bump. Park with the puck. He shoots, Smith stopped it. Leach puck, Leach took a whack at it. So Smith committed early. Daly keeping it in. Lorimer with the puck, Leach goes to him. Lorimer drives it down the ice. 48 seconds left in the Islander penalty to Bob Nystrom. Kenny Linsman, he can really skate. He'll turn it on. Didn't get through. Puck came out. Solid play by Ken Morrow. The rookie number six on the Islander defense has been one of the best in the game today. Ryan Propp led rookie scorers in the league this year with 75 points to Ben Wilson. 18 seconds left in the penalty. Linsman. Cooley to Wilson. The shot. Missed the net. Linsman to Wilson. The shot. Deflects wide. 5 seconds left in the penalty. Puck came out of the corner. Morrow breaks up the play. Another big play by Morrow. There's Nystrom out of the penalty box. Teams at full strength. 14 and a half minutes left in regulation time. 4-3 Islanders. Race for the puck. Morrow gets to it. Icing called on Philadelphia.
And a mammoth sigh of relief from the crowd as Nystrom left the penalty box.
Not only from the crowd, but also from the Islander players and Bob Nystrom. It's a terrible system to be in, sitting in the penalty box, knowing that you've taken a bad penalty, and there isn't a thing you can do about it.
I saw Ken Morrow a minute ago. Of course, he won a gold medal with the U.S. Olympic hockey team, a story often told in the last few days. What a spot for him. There it is. One goal lead. The Islanders ahead. 14:27 left, regulation time.
Hot Van Sutter in the first period, Bossy and Nystrom in the second, scoring for the Islanders and their coach, Al Arbor. Flyer goals by Leach and Propp in the first period, the big goal by Daly early in this third. McLeish coming out with Paddock, and used sparingly. Paddock goes into forecheck on Langevin. Solid hit by Paddock. Puck went around on the boards, McLeish behind the net to Bridgman. From behind the goal to the corner, Pearson checking it. Langevin behind the net, chased by Paddock and McLeish. McLeish with the puck. DuPont shot, deflects, they score! Holmgren or Paddock it is in front. I think Paddock will get credit for the goal. DuPont comes in to congratulate. It's a tied up game, 4-4. The Flyer contingent is very happy.
Well, they have come back in the first 6 minutes and 2 seconds with two unanswered goals to tie it. Boy, look at that one, Gary. Fall on a bouncing puck.
Well, again, it's a shot from the point.
Watch Paddock in front.
The Flyers have had time. It hits the skate, changes direction. Smith never had a chance on it. But it doesn't surprise you to see the Flyers come back. They've been doing it all year, and here they are again, knocking at the door.
If Paddock touched it, it's his goal, but it appeared to go off a skate instead. Could be DuPont's goal to tie it at 4-4, 6:02 of the third period, the time of that goal. And it's a brand new game. Paddock gets credit for the goal.
Number 6, Andre DuPont, and number 19, Rick McLeish.
Puck is in the mesh, dug out by
Bridgman.
Paddock got credit for the goal. DuPont and McLeish get the assist. John Paddock, 2 games in the finals, 2 goals in the finals. The replacing the injured Tom Dorrance, the new sparingly gets a big goal to tie it. Now there's 13:07 left on the big clock. Bob Nyström, joined by Trocchi. Pass one over Trocchi's stick. Mike Busnick to Bobby Clark. On his left is Barber. The pass to Barber. The shot. Smith stopped it. Swept it aside. Howitt along the boards. Checked by Leach. They will check. They will really work. It'll be frantic on that ice in this last 12:45. Trocchi goes to the puck. Brings it in. Clark takes him out. The puck went behind the goal to Peters to Daly. Trocchi steals. Pass intercepted by Clark. DuPont for Leach. Tipping it in. 4-4 tie, 12:27 left regulation time. Islanders, with Putman controlling the puck, lead the series 3-2. But right at this moment, it's anybody's game, and it's still anybody's Stanley Cup final. Howitt, checked by Propp. Checking very tight. Propp at center. Scooping it in. Lane taps it out. Daly with the puck to DuPont. Two key defensemen in this third period. Daly with a goal. DuPont with a shot that was deflected in for a goal. Sutter to the puck. The play stopped. Penalties behind the play. It's Clark Gillies. And Holmgren, the gloves are off. The two heavyweights. They were going to get minor penalties, and now they'll get more. Gillies and Holmgren. Two giants. Down they go with Holmgren on top.
Well, I think everybody has just seen that Paul Holmgren is rather strong. When you can handle Clark Gillies, hold him off that way, and end up on top of him. Boy, oh boy, you mentioned the two strongmen, Jim. That's exactly what they represent in the lineups. And now the officials will get the crowbars out and try to separate them. Boy, Gillies really took off. They clashed, they were drawing penalties. And then came the second altercation, the more serious of the two. And away they go. A couple of pretty good hockey players eliminated for the next 7 minutes or so. Please, all but eliminated for all but about 5 minutes of the rest of this regulation time. Likewise, Paul Holmgren. They have drawn a total of 7 minutes in penalties with 11:51 left.
Well, you knew they were going to come together. They were eyeing each other and then went to it, and they'll set the much latter part of this, or right to the latter part of this hockey game in the penalty box. And you know the Islanders, they're a little tentative right now. When the Flyers get the puck, their defense are backing in. They're allowing them to come over the blue line, and that's bad news if they continue to do that. Flyers have that life now, that new enthusiasm. I mean, they've had it all game, but it just regeneration. Is that what they call it, Jim?
Daly's goal turned on the switch. Holmgren cross-checking and fighting. Gillies slashing and fighting, 7 minutes each. 50 minutes of penalties to Philadelphia in the game, 40 minutes to the Islanders. It's a 4-4 tie, 11:38 left in regulation time.
Could you stand overtime today? You might have to.
Morrow goes to the puck. Ken Morrow. Or Goring too far ahead. Lane goes to the puck, watched by Bridgman. Who's going to reach down for the extra stamina to be the hero in game 6 of the Stanley Cup final? 11:08 left in regulation time, 4-all tie. Putman with the puck. Linsman moves to check. Over to Bob Lorimer. Lorimer to Butch Goring. Got away from him. Recovers the puck. Lost it to Linsman. Linsman fell. Putman fell on him. Wayne Sutter. Penalty coming up to Linsman behind the play. A backhander by Sutter went wide. The Islanders had their goaltender out for an extra attacker because Linsman takes a foolish penalty behind the play, hitting Putman, and Bob Myers picked it up.
Ken Linsman at 9:21 in this tied third period draws a penalty. Will this be a moment much talked about when it's all over?
Well, a lot of times in this game, you have to take a hit and you receive one. Linsman on a retaliation gets the 2 minutes, and if the Islanders were to score, he will not be very popular over in the Flyers bench, believe me.
You did not actually see the retaliation. It occurred when Putman got to his feet, then Linsman hit him behind the play. roughing the penalty. 9:21 the time. The score is 4-4. The Islanders have the man advantage. They've already scored two power play goals in this game. They scored 15 in the series. DuPont clears the puck out. Stefan Pearson. Denny Potvin. Up front is Bourne, 14, Sutter, or rather Bossy, number 22, and Trocheck is number 19. Bourne to Potvin. In the corner to Bourne. Back to Potvin. To Stefan Pearson. Missed it. Recovered it. Quick pass to Bossy. To Pearson. To Bourne. Back pass intercepted. Shot out by Reg Leach, who goes to the bench. The Flyers now send out Bridgman, Barber, Busnick, and Wilson to kill the penalty. 1:08 left in Lindsman's minor. Stefan Pearson with the puck. 9:43 left, regulation time. 4-4 tie. Bossy. That's Tonelli, number 27, with him. See the pressure that's affecting the play?
Jim, the Islanders are very tight. You can tell by the passes they're making. They're all behind, not on the stick.
Tonelli trying to do it himself. Lost his stick in the collision with Bridgman. Trying to do it as individuals. It's not working at this stage. 32 seconds left in the power play. Trocheck with the puck. Deflects over to Potvin. To Trocheck. They're the key men on the power play. Barber tripped up Trocheck. Stefan Pearson put it in front. Tip wide by Sutter. Tonelli around to Stefan Pearson. 10 seconds left in the power play. Sutter. Pearson's in front. Sutter with the puck. Now Tonelli goes to the front. Pearson from behind the net. The penalty's over. Lindsman's back on. Potvin shot. Good save by Peters. Flyers killed the penalty successfully. 8.5 minutes left, regulation time. It's 4-4. Sutter knocked down by Daly, and DuPont goes to the puck. There it is, Moose. Al Hill's pass tipped away. He recovers. Hill moving in on Lane. Hill turning. Rick McLeese from the corner. DuPont shot. Smith stopped it. Morrow takes off the rebound. Morrow for Howitt. Oh, just failed to pick it up. Daly to the puck. Icing called as Howitt and Daly go together on the end boards.
Well, there you see it. The time remaining in regulation play. 7 minutes and 53 seconds. The Islanders and the Flyers are tied 4-4 as Pat Quinn's Philadelphia team has come back here in the third period, trailing 4-2. Bob Daly scoring at 1:47. John Paddock at 6:02.
Harbour talking to Lorimer there at the bench. Now this faceoff is in Islander territory. Bridgman battling Trocheck, and the Islanders get possession. Lord Lane to Trocheck. On his right is Nystrom. As the puck is dumped in, Peters stops it. Nystrom after the rebound. It's steered away. DuPont with the puck. DuPont and Daly. The Flyer defense as DuPont brings it out. Dumping it in. It came to the side and Smith had to go off his skate. Daly shot it high. Lane missed it. Loose puck at the side of the net. Bridgman from the corner. To the point. Daly shot went wide. Wilson centering it. Lindsman missed a chance. Bridgman from behind the net to Lindsman. He shot. Smith stopped it. Bridgman to Lindsman. Centering it. Steered away by Morrow. And the kid from the Olympic team looks so steady on defense. Nystrom in on Daly. Fell. Joined along the boards by Howard and Daly. Stopped the play and Nystrom complains to Myers.
Boy, a close-in chance right off the edge of the goalpost. There were a few in there.
Well, the Flyers are taking it to him. Smith did a good job of keeping his position, hugging the post so he wouldn't get beat on the short side, but the points continue to be open. The Flyers are getting their shots through from the point. You know, when the pressure has been put on here by the Flyers, the Islanders, they're running all over the place now. They're a little frustrated. That's the reason that they're giving up those good shots. Clark is, Gillies, of course, is in a position he can't do a thing about it. Just sit and watch.
6 minutes, 51 seconds left in regulation time. Shot went wide of the net. Sutter shot hit Wilson. Sutter put it in front. Scramble there. There's the puck for Peters to cover up. He looks around, but he knows he's got the puck, and Howitt was trying to jam it in.
Good quick move by Peters, dropping to his knees that time. Right here, Gary, Denny Potvin is such an important man for New York. He's on that point. Had a chance right there.
I think the Islanders are certainly going to play him a lot more. You know, so if he does see a lot of ice action, that's the time for the Flyers to try to exploit him, keep firing in his corner, try to forecheck him. You know, when you're tired, you do strange things with that puck.
6:43 left in regulation time. Leach and Goring on this faceoff. Leach winning the draw. Wilson with the puck. First round draft choice 2 years ago. Ben Wilson. Now it's steered out to center. Paddock racing after the puck with Potvin. Paddock, the backhander, went wide. The place goes to the puck, bumped on the boards. It's steered to center. Goring trying to get to it. Wilson cleared it away. Lorimer to the puck. Ran into Al Hill. The puck goes loose to Potvin. It's scrambly out there as Paddock is collides. Here's a chance for Potvin. A shot went high. Goring from the corner. Sutter coming in front. His shot bounces around off the leg. Howitt from the corner. Try to center it. It's blocked. They all hammer away at that puck. 5:54 left regulation time. Time to loosen the tie. There goes that nice blue and white tie. 5:45 left. 4-4 tie. Reg Leach. Try to center the puck. Trottier picked it up. Bossy trying to get it out. Mike Bossy surrounded by Flyers. Keeps digging for the puck. Bobby Clark winds up with it. Trottier trying to check him off it. Barber slowed up on the boards by Ken Morrow. Lane with the puck. Back around to Bossy. Coming out with Bourne and Trottier. Moving in on DuPont and Daly. Bourne and Daly go after the puck. It's broken up by Daly. 5:10 left. Morrow dumps it in. Pete Peters stops it back of the goal. Clark goes to the puck. Bobby Clark to Reg Leach. On the left wing is Brian Propp. But Leach didn't get through. Morrow with the puck. To Lauren Henning. Bossy couldn't reach, couldn't control the pass. Henning taken out by Daly. Henning has replaced Merrick, who might be injured. He hasn't played much in this game. In goes Lindsman, a shot right on. Smith juggled it, but he held it. 4:38 left in regulation time. The centers were waved out. Holmgren and Henning will face off.
Now the Islanders continue to use two centermen out there, almost as if purposely get the first one thrown out so that the next center goes against the winger.
Trottier and Henning are both centers normally. They're on a line. Possibly one would go to the bench after the draw. A shot on the faceoff by Propp is blocked as it hit Potvin. That stung. Brian Trottier with the puck to Lauren Henning. He's been through it all with the Islanders since year one. Lindsman comes back. Potvin knocks it away. Leaves it now for Tonelli. Nystrom's on right wing, going for the net. Tonelli backhands it wide. Lindsman steered it, not away. Potvin shoots. Peters standing up, steered it to the corner. Buznik trying to dig it out. Nystrom's pass is blocked by Lindsman, who clears it out. 3:55, you see the time running out now, 3:54, and the regulation time, it's 4-4.
That chance for Propp off the faceoff hit Potvin in front of the net. What an opportunity that was for Philadelphia.
You know, the Islanders thought they had the advantage by having a faceoff man to go against Holmgren, but he has such strength, and he used to play center ice himself, so that was no big deal. And he showed how he could get the draw, but the faceoffs become so very important now, and both teams are thinking, gee whiz, one mistake and it could be all over. They're very aware of that.
This is just like sudden death right here. You get into the final 4 minutes of a tie game. Gillies is back along with Holmgren. They're out of the penalty box, having served their 7 minutes.
Rick McLeish, he scored a lot of goals.
Now 48
of them in the playoffs. Now the crowd here comes to its feet. So we'll have to watch a monitor rather than the ice. because they're standing in front of us. They're standing everywhere. They're trying to ignite a late Islander rally. Al Harper's been standing all night. A lot of pacing, too. 3:48 left. Puck is cleared out by Morrow. DuPont put it in the Islander zone. Lane to the puck. Worked his way to the NHL out of the International League. Marty Lane steering it out. Clark Gillies goes to the puck and dumps it in. 3:30 left. Regulation time. DuPont to Bridgman, who's out there with McLeish. Hill is number 15 on left wing as they move to the attack. Bridgman shot, deflects to the corner. Dwayne Sutter. Weak pass. Daly intercepts. Setting it up. Bridgman tipped it wide. Denny Potvin with the puck. Sutter. In on DuPont, who put the stick up in front of him. Sutter went right into the corner. Bumping with Daly. Daly winds up with the puck. On the boards. Intercepted. Potvin shot. Deflects. Peters didn't see it. It hit him and went out behind him and out the other side. Close call. Still 4-4. Lorimer watched by Barber. Broken stick on the ice. Tension in the air. 2:38 left on the clock. Dennis Potvin. Bob Bourne's called offside.
Boy, Pete Peters looked behind him after that shot came in from Potvin.
Now, close chance, and it was a deflection. Sutter was in front of Peters, deflected. I don't know, did he get part of that or did it hit the goal?
I think it hit him and went between his legs.
The fans continue to get things revved up here. Another standing ovation. That's about the third one in the last minute and a half. They love their Islanders. They make as much noise as the fans in Philadelphia.
A pretty lady said, come on, Islanders. 2:28 left. There's a Flyer contingent here. And they're saying, come on, Flyers. And they have to be very proud of their team's comeback here. 2:18 left. Trottier's shot is blocked. This is Reg Leach. He's dangerous. In on Lorimer. The shot hit Lorimer. Bounces to Smith. He'll cover up.
Boy, if Reggie Leach would have had a chance to look down the left wing there, Bobby Clark was steaming in all alone. That would have been a... that could have been it right there, Dick.
Now the Rangers have won the Cup 3 times in their long history, but never on home ice, which means that the people in New York, going way, way back, have never seen one of their teams win the Cup here in this area. Of course, you seem so far away from New York when you're in Long Island, you wonder, never mind, you're in the next county, it's like another country. But the New York Islanders.
Bill Barber from Colander, just 8 miles from North Bay. He's been in a lot of pressure situations before, and he's in one now. 2:08 left. Morrow lost the puck to Leach. Leach's shot. Smith stopped it, scooped it away. They all look a little tense and nervous out there. Linesman said the puck was kept onside. Now Bourne can't find it. Recovers. Back to Lane. 1:50 left in regulation time. It's 4-all. Lane scoops it across to Morrow. Two young defensemen. Now to Trotsky, jumping it in, gets to the bench on a line change. 1:38 left, regulation time. That little disc is what they're trying to use to break this tense tie. Linsman lost it to Henning, who steered it outside the line. Puck is held long enough to stop the play.
1:26, the time remaining. If we don't get a goal in that time, it's overtime. Al Harper.
The coaches certainly earn their paycheck right now. Make sure they make the right moves. Get the right face-off men out there. Get the right checkers out in certain situations.
Well, I tell you, a Cup Final Series has gone the full seven-game distance only once in the last 14 years and only 3 times in the last 24 years. And the Flyers are putting on quite a show here today to try to force that situation this year.
1:24, you see the clock running down with a minute 20 left now. 4-4 tie. Lorimer goes to the puck. Holmgren goes into check. Bumps him. Potvin gets the puck. This is Lauren Henning. On his right is Bob Nystrom. Nystrom couldn't quite reach the puck. Potvin keeps it onside. No, says Ron Finn. Puck Man argues. Ron Finn says it came up, and he will win the argument.
1:02. That's the big story right here, the time.
Well, one thing, the officials, they had a good view of it. Let's have a look. Puck Van going in for that puck, trying to keep it inside that blue line. Ron Finn, he's got the best look at it. He's standing right there, so I don't think you can argue on that call.
Finn's 11th year as an NHL linesman, right on top of the play. 1:02 left in regulation time. Up at the top of the picture there, it's Bridgman bumping into Myers as they have a little argument. Bridgman was deciding to come back. Some argument about line changes. Bridgman out there with McLeishan, Holmes, and on defense, Daly and DuPont. We're in the last minute of regulation time. It's 4-4. Nystrom failed to get through, but it's a two-line pass, so it's an offside play.
Well, what a battle we have here for the final shift. Clark against Trottier, Leach and Bourne, Barber and Bossy. Oh, you can't ask for any more than that.
There's the situation with the time clock. It's a 4-4 tie. Islanders leading the series 3-2. Trottier wins a faceoff. Hot Van lost it momentarily. Leach on the left for Barber. He shoots. Smith stopped it. Everybody screamed and yelled. That wasn't a whistle. Lorimer rushing. Lorimer still working for the puck. Daly goes to it. 30 seconds now. You'll see that time clock, and we'll mention it from time to time, too, because it's so important. Offside called at the Islander line. Still 23 seconds left. Is there going to be a hero on this last shift? Clark, Barber, Leach, Daly, and Buznik on the ice for Philadelphia. Goring, Gillies, Sutter, the forward line for the Islanders. Lane with the puck. Morrow, the other defenseman, as Lane steers it for Gillies. Can't pick it up. Might be icing. No, called off by the linesman. Daly puts it on the boards. Lane brought it in offside. The teams almost look like they are ready for overtime now. 10 seconds left.
Well, this is no mistake time, I guess, Gary, really.
Unless you have a good opportunity to get the puck, you just look to see where your man is. Make sure you have him. Don't take any chances. For the Flyers, they can't afford to take chances and lose that way.
Buznik, checked by Goring. Gillies jumped it in. 4 seconds. It's going to be overtime. The tension will continue until one goal decides this one. Pressure on everyone, especially the goaltenders. Pete Peters of the Flyers, Billy Smith of the Islanders. The first goal wins the game. It might win a Stanley Cup. Smith steers it to Potvin. Potvin and Lorimer, the defense with Clark out in front, pushing with Lorimer. Pass deflects to center. This is Trottier called offside. And the Islanders complain as the puck may have tipped off Daly, but it's an offside call for a two-line pass. Face off in Islander territory.
What a spot for the Islanders. Brian Trottier, whoever, if they happen to get the goal. Last two times the Stanley Cup has been won on an overtime goal. 1977 in Boston. Jacques Lemaire for the Canadiens. 1970 in Boston. Bobby Orr for the Bruins.
Face off. When they line up, will be Clark against Trottier, and they look ready. Clark to DuPont. A shot went wide. Smith scooped the puck to the corner. Barber hustles to it there. Clark on the inboards. Tied up by Trottier. Clark with the puck. Bounces around. Leach picked it up. Shot went off a leg. Clark and Potvin after the puck. Flyers putting on early pressure. Now Mike Bossy comes out. Bossy moving in on DuPont. Trottier went to the puck. DuPont broke up the play. Comes back to Clark. Leach breaking on the right. Bridge Leach. Shoots. It deflects wide. Barber knocked down. Puck came around to Bossy. DuPont rushes at him. Bossy dumped it out. Gillies and Daly go to the puck. Bob Daly pulling away from Clark. Gillies. 1 minute gone in overtime. Oh, Lindsman was almost in the clear. Lindsman from the corner. Potvin intercepts. Potvin at the end of a long shift. To Mike Bossy, who's at the end of a long shift. So he'll dump it in. Get to the net. Oh, was he hit at center. by Prop as the two collided, one coming off the bench, one going to it. Morrow, Linsman steals the puck. Smith kicked it away. A minute and 30 gone in overtime. Clark Gilley shoots it in. Sutter hustles in. Hustle by Sutter. Lost the puck to Wilson. Play broken up by Tonelli. Now Linsman, with his great skating speed, comes in with Prop. Linsman goes to the puck, but it's knocked out of the air with a stick above the shoulder. That'll stop the play.
Now, there was a good example right there, I'm sorry, Dick, of how speed can certainly be a determining factor. When Linsman got out there with his speed, you know, almost set up the winning goal.
Oh, that puck just popped away from him. Wonder if you get inside Ken Morrow's head to compare what his feeling is like to say that U.S.-Soviet game in Lake Placid or the gold medal pitcher.
I think that guy there has aged since the last game.
Oh, even the mask is suffering.
You stole everybody's line with that one.
He's probably aged a bit today, too, Bob Myers. Pat Quinn doesn't show it, but maybe a few more gray hairs in that scalp today.
We played a minute and 44 seconds of overtime. It's four off. Lauren Henning with the puck. Moving in on Busnick. Henning from the inboard. Loose back of the net. Busnick tied up by Nyström. This is Rick McLeish. Bridgman breaks in ahead of him. McLeish takes it in. Hit by Langevin, high and hard. Flyers yelling for a penalty at their bench as Langevin really decked Rick McLeish. Busnick tied up by Henning in the corner. Henning tried to dig out the puck. It's centered. Stephen Pearson can't reach it to keep it onside. Now he plays it back. Langevin chasing the puck. Barber chases Langevin. 2.5 minutes gone in overtime. Four all. Henning with the puck. Bumped off it at the line. As the glove went flying, the Flyers have the puck. Bobby Clark has Leach on his right. Clark shoots high. Going for those high corners that Jacques Clark was talking about on Smith. Nyström. Checked from behind by Clark, but got the puck to center ice. Bobby Clark with it. Went off of Tonelli. Tonelli working in the Flyer zone. Barber bumped by Bossy, but keeps going, and Barber golfs the puck in. 3:05 played in overtime. 4-4. Kotvan rushes. Bossy with the puck. Kotvan brings it in. Bumped by Daly. Mike Bossy shoots. Deflects wide. Bob Bourne from the corner. Battle for the puck. Prop steers it to Holmgren. Linsman speeding to join him. Linsman trying to go through. Puck is scooped to the line. It bounces off Prop. He kicked it in. Linsman fell by himself in the corner. Puck is still in play. Holmgren checked behind the net. Linsman shoots. It's blocked. Smith covered up the puck. Close call.
You know, even in this tension-filled overtime, I get a kick out of the fact that, Gary, everybody on the Flyers' bench is standing up. They don't sit down and watch the game. Nobody in the Islanders' bench stands up. I've noticed that throughout the series. There they go. Look, see that? And that's the way you look at during the games. It's been so often you see that.
Well, you wonder which is the better route to go.
I don't know.
You know, the Islanders trying to keep calm and cool. But, you know, as this game goes on, we keep mentioning how important line changes are. We've seen on earlier occasions where it has resulted in a break. So the only time you want to change is when you're going into the offensive zone and fire it in deep. Then if you can, everybody go off.
There's Ken Linsman waiting for a face-off against Butch Goring. 4-4 tie. Islanders lead the series 3-2. Islanders Lane with the puck. Gord Lane to Bob Bourne. Too far ahead for Goring. Daly with the puck. Bourne hustles to it. Daly slowed him up. Tripped him up. DuPont scooped the puck out. 4 minutes gone in overtime. 4-4. First goal wins it. If after 20 minutes it's still 4-all, an intermission, and then another overtime period. Now an offside stops the play. Butch Goring and Rick McLeish getting ready to face off. Leon Stickle drops the puck. Busnick in possession for the Flyers. Shooting it in. It's loose. Hill goes to the puck. Smith picked it out of the air. Steered it to Sutter. Sutter's pass knocked down. Hill with the puck. Dumping it in, it went out of play at right at Phil Mears' feet at the Flyer bench.
Kermit made a save that will not count in the official statistics, and now passes the puck to some souvenir hunters in behind. Well, there are so many people who have never been in this situation. Not too many have, Gary, really.
Now, Billy Smith sees the opportunity to grab a hold of that puck and then lays it down and passes it up to his winger. It's a real asset when a goaltender can make that right decision and also make the play up to the winger.
Stephen Pearson is number 7 with the puck. To Lauren Henning, shooting it in. Peters missed it back of the net. Buznik put it on the board. There's a battle there. Tonelli gets the puck. Buznik checked in. Bridgman bumping along the boards with Henning. Rick McLeish coming out. Moving in on Langevin and Pearson. So he dumps it in. Langevin to the puck. Stephen Pearson steered it out. Battle on the boards. There's been a lot of battles there today. 5:04 played in overtime. Langevin shooting it in. Hit Daly. Went into the Islander bench.
It's Goresh's turn to make an unofficial save. Those guys are tired out there, I tell you. There are some of them, they just, when they are boarded or hit the boards, I tell you, Gary, it takes that extra couple of seconds to push off, and it's understandable.
Well, the shifts will become shorter and shorter. Again, it's to make sure you go off at the proper time. The coach, you know, if you go up and down your on the ice once and you're working hard and you feel tired, that's the time to go to the bench and get fresh troops out there.
Dave talked about prediction spot fans out there. Okay. Nobody's asked me, but if they did, I'd pick
good. DuPont hit Park with a pass. DuPont back to the corner for the puck, put it off the boards. Barber steers it down the ice. Icing is waved off. Play will continue as Lorimer goes back for the puck. Leach goes in to check. Park goes in too, almost stole the puck with an anticipated pass back of the net. DuPont keeping it in, took a check, took a whack at Krejci. Play goes on. Bossy shoots over the goal. Lord Porn hustles to the puck. Daly took him to the ice. Krejci goes after the puck, hit Barber. Shot by Blum, loose puck in front. Bossy to the corner. To the point. Podvan's shot blocked by Daly. The Flyers come out. Leach and Barber. The pass misses Barber. Lorimer goes to the puck. 6 minutes gone in overtime. 4-4. Krejci with the puck. Born and Bossy with him. Peters handles it easily. Leaves it for Ben Wilson. Islanders on a full change. Prop for Linsman who's so dangerous. Goring and Sutter. Goring shoots. Block. Dilly. Oh, the goal went right off its moorings. I wonder who did that.
That was Sutter. He was heading for the net, but what a good play Goring made to cut into the center of the ice and try to get that shot away.
Goring has a couple of overtime goals in his career, both for the LA Kings. Here it is, Gary.
And now watch him cut to the center. Good play. And you notice Sutter, he keeps going for the net for the possible rebound. And then takes the net with him.
Buznik was the defenseman who checked Sutter as they took the goal off its moorings.
Right now, Jim, you know the centermen, they have to make sure they have every one of their guys positioned properly before that puck is dropped.
They're on the foul is standing here, as you can see, and we can't. We can see the crowd, but we can't see the ice right now. Now we can. Thanks a lot, fellas. 6:19. Played in overtime. 4-4 tie. That's Ben Wilson with the puck. 4-4 tie. Linsman scooping it out. Morrow breaks it up. Takes it in. Put it to the corner. Wilson got to it first. Put it off the glass. Linsman racing after it. So is Morrow. Morrow won the race. Gets the icing call. Two good young hockey players in the game of their lives. Henning is number 10 of the Islanders. McLeish is number 19 of the Flyers on the faceoff. Philadelphia with the puck. Al Hill. Romel Bridgman, a couple of boys from beautiful Vancouver Island. And it's a long ways from their mind right now. Daly goes to the puck. Took a hit from Nystrom. 4-4 tie, 7 minutes gone in overtime. Henning. Pass right on the stick of Tonelli. Coming in with Nystrom. Tonelli to Nystrom. He scores! Bob Nystrom scores the goal. The Islanders win the Stanley Cup.
The handshakes. Dennis Potvin and Ben Wilson. Wayne Merrick, who didn't play much today. Buznik and Potvin. Linsman. A great moment. Especially for the Islanders.
Two tremendous hockey clubs. They put on a demonstration that they both can be proud of. Unfortunately, there only can be one winner. There is your goal scorer, Bob Nystrom, on a perfect feed. You know that line, they had the worst minus throughout this playoff, and here they come back to get the winning goal.
The time of the winning goal in overtime, as McElhaughey congratulates Nystrom, was 7 minutes and 11 seconds. Nystrom from Tinelli at 7:11. There may have been a second assist, but I didn't hear it.
You know what? It's amazing that the players can bang each other around for six games and then congratulate each other when it's all over.
The Islanders win the series 4-2. It started slowly, but it wound up a great final. There's the hero of the day and the year. The final game 5-4 in overtime. Nystrom very much involved all day, 21 minutes in penalties, but that'll be forgotten. Two goals for Nystrom today, one that goes into the record books.
Now we'll have a look at it, but it's the Tinelli Nystrom combination resulted in a 2-on-1 break. Look at Nystrom now heading for the net. There's the perfect pass. It's just a deflection. Peters, no chance on the play. The Flyers were trying to come back. There he is, the man of the hour. Something that he will never, ever forget.
Bob Nystrom, born in Sweden, raised in Kamloops.
Tough play for Pete Peters. Here's the way he looks at it. And he was very depressed after the game. The players came over to him, patted him on the pads. Bob Daly was just not able to get back and prevent the goal scoring of Bob Nystrom.
The celebration goes on. The Stanley Cup is on the ice, and there it is.
Captain of this hockey club.
be too far from that hockey team. That's the best team.